Hi everybody, I'm Sarah Ockwell-Smith. Welcome to this week's SOS parenting video. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about toddler naps and specifically how old they are when they drop them, signs that they might be about to drop them, and what to expect during the transition process. What I tend to find is that most toddlers drop their nap completely, so I mean no more daytime sleep, between 2 and 3 years of age. But if we think about this sort of normal curve of distribution, so most will drop it between 2 and 3, but you have the outliers. So I would say from sort of 18, 20 months up to 2 years, there'll be a handful, sort of 5-10% of children will drop their nap early. And then you'll have sort of 5 or 10% who will drop it after 3, so sort of 3.5, even 4 years of age. But for the majority, between 2 and 3. However, I wouldn't be worried with a child dropping their nap at 18, 19, 20 months, or a child dropping at 3.5 or 4 years. What are the signs that they need to drop a nap? These can be a bit tricky to interpret because actually there could be signs of lots of things, but the characteristic ones I look for are night waking reoccurring or becoming more common, so more waking in the night. Bedtime resistance, so you're finding it harder and harder to get them to sleep at bedtime. So bedtime is becoming later, or they're sort of doing everything possible to string it out, and they're really finding it difficult to go to sleep, or they'll go to sleep and they'll wake up 45 minutes later or something. But there's generally some resistance at bedtime. Earlier morning waking, so they may already be waking early, but you may find that the waking becomes even earlier. And the last sign is that maybe they are starting to refuse that nap, or you're finding it harder to get them to take the nap, or they may be waking earlier in when they have the nap. However, you can also have a toddler who naps brilliantly, who goes to sleep really easily and sleeps for an hour or 2 hours, who is very much ready to drop their nap. In that case, I would be looking for signs at the night. Don't be confused and think, my toddler naps really well, they go to sleep really easily, they sleep for an hour or two, so they must need it. If you have signs with bedtime resistance, more night waking and more early morning waking. So I'd look for one of those signs. They tend to be better signs than what a child does around their nap time. So what happens when you drop the nap? So there are two ways for this to happen. Either you can let it happen entirely naturally. This is quite a long process, I would say. It could take anywhere from sort of 3 to 12 months. And what you'll find happen is some days they'll have a nap, some days they won't. Some days their naps will be shorter, some days it will be longer. Bedtime onset will probably be a little bit all over the place because when they nap, they probably need a later bedtime. And actually, that's fine. One thing I haven't said is it's great to keep the nap if you want to, but we have this obsession with children still having naps and an early bedtime. And what you find is they get older, they don't need as much sleep. So if you want to retain the nap, you need to push their bedtime later, sort of a 9 or 10 p.m. bedtime if they're still having a nap. You can't be having that 7 or 8 p.m. bedtime and a nap if they don't need that much sleep. So that's what happens naturally. A bit all over the place, can take several months. The alternative is to take a parental control. And by no means is this not gentle. I think a lot of people think you should let children do things entirely naturally. And I think actually you have to consider the whole family and also the child as well. I would have no issue with controlling a toddler nap drop. So what we're doing here is effectively we're just trying to help the toddler to stay awake with lots of distraction. Try to avoid anything that makes them fall asleep when they're looking tired. So avoid going in the car, avoid cuddling or breastfeeding or something like that at a danger zone time. Try and keep them awake. Lots of dancing, lots of loud music, lots of getting outside and running around. And if they do accidentally fall asleep, then just try to wake them up as soon as possible. If they accidentally fall asleep and you can't wake them, that's fine. Forget that day, try again the next day. But you're just trying to keep them awake. Now, what is important is you do not bring bedtime forward to compensate. A lot of people do this. But what you find is the sleep issues at night still remain because the child needs to drop their nap because they need less sleep in a 24-hour period. If you bring bedtime forward to compensate for the nap drop, you're not allowing them to drop that sleep. So bedtime stays the same. Don't bring it forward. However hard it is, however tired your child is, try to keep bedtime at the normal time. So what you find, what to expect, is it's really difficult for anywhere between sort of 4 to 8 weeks. This nap drop is not easy by any means. You'll have a grouchy, overtired child because what you'll find is when you drop the nap, their night sleep won't improve for a month or so. So temporarily, they're going to be sleep deprived. They're going to be really grouchy, really grumpy in the afternoons and evenings. Their night waking actually may get worse for a month. But a lot of parents then think, oh, this is the wrong thing to do. My child is obviously not ready to drop their nap because they're very grouchy without it, or because they wake more, or they wake early in the morning. It must be the wrong thing to do. No, it's not the wrong thing to do. You've just misinterpreted how long the transition takes. So 4 to 8 weeks of, unfortunately, tired, grouchy toddler, worsened night sleep, really tricky days, tricky nights, but stick with it. Once the most important thing about parenting and gentle parenting and sleep is that you have consistency. You have empathy for the child, so you're not getting angry at them. You're reminding yourself it's difficult for them too, but you're consistent. If you decide it's time for the nap to go, don't be flip-flopping backwards and forwards between having it and not having it. Remind yourself this is a transition. It takes at least a month. Things are going to be hard for that month, so try to plan the drop if possible around a time where you haven't got much else happening, like a holiday, if we ever get those again. And just really focus that, yeah, okay, this is normal, that temporarily their behavior is going to get worse and their sleep is going to get worse, but give it at least a month until you look at how the nap drop has gone. And I would say most of them, after a month, you'll see a big improvement in behavior and a big improvement in night sleep. But it is not a quick process, and it's not the wrong thing to do to drop the nap if you find it tricky. It's normal. I hope that helped. Thank you. Bye.